Today I have with me Mark McCully, Vice President of Production for Certified Angus Beef, and we're talking about the value of the beef carcass. So Mark, we see different prices for beef, from the price in the grocery store to live cattle price, cutout. Can you explain what all these mean?
Yeah, there really are, and you picked up the three big ones. The live cattle price, that's simply the price per pound that cattle feeders would sell cattle to the packer. The cutout is really the wholesale value of the beef. So box beef sales from the packer out to the next level of the distributor and the retailer. Then, of course, that retail price is that what the retailer or the grocer prices it at that the consumer is paying at the grocery store.
So we hear a lot about the beef cutout. Can you explain where that value comes from?
Yeah, that cutout is important because the spreads between the different value cutouts is what's so important on fed cattle marketing grids today. And so that cutout value really originates through mandatory price reporting. The USDA collects all of the data of the packer's sales of box beef onto the next tier of distribution, and the price is paid for all those individual pieces and parts, the subprimals and the cuts. Then all that prices are taken and rolled up into a primal price and ultimately calculated up into a total carcass cutout value. And they do that for select and choice and prime and no roll. And the differences between those cutouts is what's so important and we pay a lot of attention to as it relates to demand for premium.
So are there certain specific cuts that are driving that price higher?
Yeah, I think in the choice select spread, we've historically seen the middle meats really is where the premiums are being paid on the rib and the loin cuts. And therefore, we see that choice select spread being largely driven off those cuts. That's changed here recently, and in particular with the Certified Angus Beef brand, where we also have a premium above the choice price in the marketplace, but we see our partners also paying premiums for round meat, chuck meat, ground beef in particular, and so it's driving a premium across the entire carcass.
Right now we have record beef supplies, record quality beef supplies. Is that impacting these spreads?
It is to some effect. We have produced a tremendous amount of quality beef today between the tremendous grade of what cattlemen have produced along with increased cattle inventory. So those two combined have produced some really large high quality beef inventories in the marketplace. And we've seen those spreads compress just a little bit. But when we look at the Certified Angus Beef spread, it's actually maintained really well considering we have increased sales at a tremendous amount. We think going forward, as cattle supplies get tighter, the demand for high quality is not going away. We see those spreads, we think, will continue to get larger in the future.
Thanks, Mark. For the Certified Angus Beef Market Report, I'm Nicole Ersig.